judge in that. The senior judge was.
So is that allowed, sir, to give one judgment and then to overrule your own judgment later?
Because he was actually a part of the bench. There is nothing wrong in it, because if they can reconsider it. That is, in Shafi Mohammed's case, the judgment dated 3rd April 2018. जरा ओपन करेंगे आप, शफी मोहम्मद वर्सेस स्टेट ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश, जजमेंट डेटेड 3rd April 2018, दैट इज गिवन बाय जस्टिस ए के गोयल एंड जस्टिस नरीमन. देर आर टू जजमेंट ऑफ शफी मोहम्मद. वन इज गिवन बाय जस्टिस यू यू ललित एंड जस्टिस गोयल. First judgment is 30th January 2018. Second judgment is 30th April 2018. So when you open 3rd April 2018, Justice Nariman is a party to that. Paragraph number 4, he overrules his judgment. Where in the interest of justice, equity and good conscience, they can do that. Are you able to trace that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Now, in that paragraph number 4, may say the applicability of requirement of certificate being procured can be relaxed by the court whenever the interest of justice, whenever the interest of justice so requires. Uske andar likha ho, padhiye. Wo paragraph hai, wo padhiye. Relevant hai. Because in the present Evidence Act, the interest of justice don't come into play. Under Section 64B, subclause 4, issuance of certificate is mandatory. It cannot be relaxed now. That is what the judgment of three-judge bench says. That is Arjun Pandit Rao Khotkar's case. I will be dealing with it. Let everybody join. Let us deal with it. So the judgment will be discussed. State, that is a NCT of Delhi, that is a Navjot Sandhu's case, 2005-11 SEC, which was a judgment delivered by two judge bench of Justice Venkatrama Reddy and Justice Nyolekar. Now when you open this relevant paragraph of the judgment of the state NCT versus Navjot, paragraph number 15 kholiye tha na, paragraph call record proof of authenticity. Very important submissions were made by Mr. Shanti Bhushan, the senior lawyer appearing in that matter for the accused person. Can you open paragraph number 15? Hamare paas computer mein it is a page number 56 hai. Wahan pe the heading start call record proof and authenticity, item number 15 mentioned kiya in the middle. Are you able to lay it? Gitanshu or Ashish, you can lay your hand.
Yes, sir. Only one minute, sir.
State NCT of Delhi versus Navjot Singh, Afsang Guru's case, say famously known as a parliament attack case.
Sir, do you think there was also some people who were involved in that case that did not figure in the trial, sir? And then what, as a lawyer, what is the best way to account for that, sir?
That we cannot give opinion unless we know the entire history of the case. But I was not part of the trial, unfortunately. We will have to go by what the record says. Because the law laid down in that judgment was that here, the Shanti Bhushan, the advocate, took up the plea that year. Call record relating to cellular phones which were being used as an evidence without certificate under Section 65B of the Evidence Act. That you see that. Then in that connection, the learned judge, the bench says, paragraph number 65 mein kehte hain, it may be that certificate containing details in subsection 4 of 65B is not filed in the instant case. But that does not mean secondary evidence cannot be given if the law permits such evidence to be given in the circumstances mentioned in the relevant provision, namely 63 and 65. So before I discuss the judgment, I want to take you all through the relevant provisions of the Indian Evidence Act permitting in what cases secondary evidence is permissible. If everybody join, if you tell me when to start, then we'll make the beginning.
So we can start, sir. We can start.
Yeah. Just open your Bare Act of the Indian Evidence Act. So we had discussed earlier that pehle section 59 khol lijiye aap. That is a topic dealing with chapter 4, oral evidence. 59, see section 59 kehta hai, all facts except the content of documents or electronic records may be proved by oral evidence. That means electronic records as mentioned in the Information Technology Act. When you open Information Technology Act, what is the meaning of electronic record? Aapko mil jayega. Electronic record is defined in Section 2F. Please open your Information Technology Act 2000. Electronic record Evidence Act mein define nahi kiya gaya hai. It is defined in Section 2F. Electronic record means data recorded or a data generated, image or sound stored, received or sent in an electronic form or a microfilm or a computer generated microfiche. Now again, you will have to see the meaning of what is data here. When you see the definition of data, section 2. One minute, can you give me? Yes, give me. No, you all can hear me. Sorry. Hello.
Yes, I'm so sorry.
Yes, there was an important. Yeah. So again, Section 2F defines electronic record, then which means a data recorded. That the interpretation data, the meaning of data is a Section 2O. 2O. See, data mean representation of information, knowledge of facts, concept or instruction which are being prepared or have been prepared in a formalized manner and is intended to be processed, is being processed or has been processed in a computer system or a computer network and may be in any form including computer printout, magnetic or optical storage media, a punch card or punch tapes, or stored internally in a memory of the computer. So this is the meaning of a electronic record, which you should know when they are used in Section 59 of the Indian Evidence Act. That means you are not permitted to lead. Oral evidence cannot be allowed to be given by in respect of documents or electronic records. That is what Section 59 says. So this amendment came in the year 2000 when the Information Technology Act came. So this is the best,
Sir, sorry to disturb you, sir, but 2F here talks about asymmetric crypto system. So that definition is not, at least in the act that I'm referring, 2F is something else only.
No, 2T. T for Telangana, T for, you say? Got it? Electronic record?
Section 2T.
Electronic okay, record means data recorded, generated. So that Thank is you. The meaning of electronic record. So what is used in Section 59 of the Evidence Act? The expression data is used in 2O. So you cannot prove the electronic record by oral evidence. That means you require either a primary evidence or a secondary evidence. So primary evidence means the document itself. That is the original. Suppose from your cell phone, you have taken a videograph of the scene of offense, of the photograph. So the contents in your mobile phone can be called primary evidence because the pictures are taken from your mobile phone. But you have transferred the pictures to me and your friends by WhatsApp, by various mode, they don't become primary evidence. They are secondary evidence. Transmission takes place, right? Because nowadays everybody is forwarding by email, by WhatsApp, by various chats. You know,
doesn't that become hearsay, sir?
It is not hearsay. It is a document in a printed form, which is a copy. What you are forwarding is not a original. The original copy which you are forwarding me, I am receiving it is a copy from you. So that copy cannot be proved, is not a original document. It becomes a secondary evidence because it's a copy. Now, what is the secondary evidence? Please see the illustration, section 63. Secondary evidence ke matlab yahan check kar lijiye aap. Secondary evidence mean and include certified copies given under the provisions hereinafter contain. Normally, certified copies are given when you apply for a court record, judgment copy. Certified copy of the election record, isn't it? Certified copy under the RTI. Ab jo bhi apply karenge, they are certified copies of a public document, anything, any document. Number two, copies made from the original by mechanical process, which in themselves ensure the accuracy of a copy, and copies compared with such copy. Now here, number two can be a Xerox copy. Now the original mark sheet is in your possession, which you obtained from the Government Law College or University of Mumbai, and you are giving copies to various people. So what you apply here, you go to the Xerox machine and take a copy. Isn't it? You produce in the court of law. You produce in the court of law, for example, I am challenging the agreement of sale dated so-and-so. So, agreement of sale may be in your possession, original document, which is registered. Naturally, in the court of law, you are not producing the original document. So, you take out a Xerox copy. So, the Xerox copy, you mention it here. This Xerox copy has been taken by me by using the original from the Xerox machine at so-and-so. The contents are correct. Samjana? In the first case,
certified copies even from the court order is considered secondary evidence. Then how you get? How you get primary? How will you get the original copy? So you can't, because only the parties concerned will get
The original copy is signed by the judge. It is kept in record. That will not be given. the judgment copy which has been signed by the honorable judges is in the court record. So that is the original document.
So all court records will only be secondary evidence.
Yes, exactly. You are applying for certified copy. They are certified copy. They are permissible. Certified copies plus they are also coming within the meaning of Section 74 public documents. See that? 74 mein aa jayenge na public document. So they become easily admissible. Even under the RTI jo application lete hain aap, it is a certified copy. From the collector ke paas se your sale deed, your conveyance must have been misplaced. You do not have your property records of your grandfather's property. Are they? You are going for a partition of your property. You are claiming a right under a particular conveyance. So the conveyance may not be with you. You go to the collector's office and obtain certified copies. So certified forming, the collector signs the copies and gives you a copy. Yes, so this is from my record. So 63-1 mein aa jayega. Then 63-2 ke andar kya aayega? The Xerox copy which you have taken yourself as a private document, which you produce in the court of law to rely upon for certain purposes, maybe for cancellation of the deed, maybe for partition of the property, family property, maybe for a declaration that the agreement is sham, colorable and bogus, be set aside. So there can be various reasons why you use this. Okay, then number 3 aa jaiye. Copies made from or compared with the original. So yahan pe again 2-3 also copies made from or compared with the original. So the earlier one you are taking Xerox copy directly. So yahan pe you may be having 2-3 copies. Sometime you make a Lehman license ke do copy banayenge, 3 copy banayenge on a stamp paper of 500 rupees. Bolega the first is a original copy, second also is a stamp paper, but it's a carbon copy. It is the contents are same with the one.
Sir, but whether a multiple copies like this, don't they ideally come as counterparts that parties to the agreement or deed get the multiple copies, but each copy is recognized as original?
They are counterparts. They are coming under clause 4. Like, see, counterparts of document against parties who did not execute them. So they can be counterpart, mean they are containing the same similar contents, same signature, but it is not the first piece. The first document is elsewhere. The first document may be with the defendant, may be with the registrar, may be at home, may be misplaced. So you are relying upon the secondary evidence because the primary evidence originally is not available. So when it doesn't become available circumstances, I will give you that is given under Section 65. And so, you have to
So all counterparts are just copies. No matter what you do, they are not originals.
They are all copies. Then kindly see item number 5. Oral accounts of contents of documents given by some person who himself has seen it. So sometime oral account of contents of a document given by someone who himself has seen it. So sometime it is also the oral account. It is not only the Xerox copies or original copies.
So I just had a query regarding these counterparts. For each of the counterparts, don't we pay stamp duty for each of the copies to recognize them as original in itself?
I mean, you don't pay much counter stamp duties. Only a minor amount of 10 rupees or 5 rupees is affixed to these copies. They are not the required copies. You are not supposed to pay the maximum court fees under the Act.
So I think, correct me, but I think what I am trying to understand from our Aparna's question is, so why do we do it? It's just a waste of money.
It's a waste of money, because you may say that to give the authenticity, somebody has to say, yes, the original is with me and the copy which I am giving it to Mr. XYZ is the same copy which has been compared. Like you go to the Government Law College, Bombay, for your admission. you show your previous mark sheets, isn't it? You need not bring the original one. Wo bolenge xerox copy leke aaiye, but notarized copies. And notarized copies also are valid copies.
But sir, then essentially they lose their value of being then called a counterpart. You might just call them as photocopies and leave it.
Yes.
Because
they are giving a particular nomenclature or name on it. Okay? Then see item number 5, oral account of contents of documents given by some person who has himself seen it. So somebody may say that, yes, I have seen A adopting B. See, under the Hindu law, for taking an adoption, you need not have a document. Understand, na? An elderly person may see, yes, I have seen my neighbor taking this young boy of the neighbor in adoption. They have undergone some ceremony. They wrote down something. The village panchayat gentleman came down and wrote down something. I saw everything. So he is giving oral account of the content document. A document means maybe a deed of adoption. Like under the Mohammedan law, you know that here, a gift deed need not be in writing. A gift can be oral. Have you heard of this? Hibanama.
Yes, sir.
In the family law, you learned it. A Hibanama is under the Indian Transfer of Property Act, Section 124 mandate, the gift deed must be registered. Whereas the Mohammedan law says that a gift deed, a Hibanama, need not be registered. It can be oral. A declaration can be made, a declaration made by two witnesses stating that they have heard Mr. X giving property to his son and daughter equally, is a oral account of the document. He made a declaration. So the oral, it's a hearsay evidence that can be given in respect, that becomes a secondary evidence. Take for example the illustration. A photograph of a original is secondary evidence of its content. Though the two have been compared, it is proved that the thing photographed was original. So, aapke photograph se photo khiche aapne, you transfer it to somebody, it's a secondary evidence. And you have black and white in those days, the black was considered the positive, the negative, and the white copy is a positive. And white copy positive is not a primary evidence. Only the black reels were the negative, were negatives, and they were the primary document. Aap samjhe na aap? So these are the example. Number 2, a copy compared with a copy of a letter made by a copying machine is a secondary evidence of the content of the letter. It is shown that the copy made by copying machine was made from the original. So you have to prove that the sale deed, Xerox copy which have exhibited the plane, has been taken out from the original. I did not want to give the original in the court or to the defendant. So he demanded inspection. I had the original, I gave him inspection. He took inspection. And on the spot, I have taken a copy and made a copies thereof. So those copies become secondary evidence. Then you wrote it down on the Xerox copies, true copy. Aap khud likhe sign kar diye. Self-attested copies is allowed now, isn't it? Now aapke Aadhaar card banaye aapne. And you are giving it a copies to everybody, income tax department, yes, your department. Yes, you are signing. So it's a secondary evidence. Now C mein check karein aap. A copy transcribed from a copy, but afterwards compared with the original, is secondary evidence. But the copy not so compared is not secondary evidence of the original, although the copy from which it was transcribed was compared with the original. So you have to, while giving evidence in the court of law, you just cannot say I am producing Xerox copy. The court will not take it. the quote, you must say the copy which is sought to be produced by me has been obtained from the original. Samjhna aap? Then only it becomes original. Then the court may ask you, where is the original? Original is either lost or in the custody of the collector, gone for stamping, or at the moment not available. That those reasons you'll have to give why they are lost, I will come to later on. Okay, then four. Neither an oral account nor a copy of which original. Yeah, okay. So this is section 73 gives you the illustration with regard to what is secondary evidence. Now, 65 is important. Now, 64 to kehta ke primary evidence must be given by document. We are not into it. Now, 65 dekhiye, cases in which secondary evidence relating to document may be given. When you are permitted, section 63 deals with a situation. What is the meaning of a secondary evidence? And 65 deals with a situation. When the secondary evidence you are permitted to be given in respect of secondary evidence. The secondary evidence may be given of the existence, condition or contents of a document in the following cases. So this section speaks of a three situation. You are allowed to give secondary evidence as regard the existence of a document. You may take up the plea that my grandfather had made this will. I had seen it myself. He used to keep it in a big almari. The robbers came and rob our house. All documents have been ransacked and taken away. My grandfather during his lifetime was in touch with the CA or the advocate. He used to give them copies of the document. I have myself personally seen that particular copy. So, you are giving evidence with regard to the existence of the document. So, the document was existing, yes. It was in what condition? It was in almari. It was in a safe or a bank locker. My father used to take me to the bank locker. In the bank locker, it was kept in a safe condition. I am also aware of the contents of the document because my father made this document or my grandfather made the document. He had called me to write it down in my own hand. I wrote it down. See that here? So you are a person witnessing it, so you know the contents of the document. My grandfather was not an educated person. So he used, whenever he wanted to write down something, some account, so he used to tell me. So he is aware of the existence, condition, as well as the content of the document. So a third party is giving the account is permissible. Then see, when the original is shown or appear to have been in the possession and power of the person against whom document is sought to be proved, now you may take up the plea that I am filing a suit for cancellation of the registered deed. The builder has not given me possession. I have made full payment. There is no likelihood that the flat will come. We executed document. The original document is still in the possession of the builder. Now he has given me a copy. So when you file a suit for cancellation of the document, what you will mention in the plain? The plaintiff submits that by virtue of the agreement of sale dated so-and-so, the plaintiff agreed to purchase from the defendant flat number so-and-so. Consideration was paid, honored. Then later on, the defendant came to know that the land on which the building is sought to be put up is an illegal land which does not belong to the defendant. It belongs to third party. Then I came to know that the municipal corporation has not granted permission to the developer on account of various breaches he has committed. in this scenario, the defendant has committed several breaches and played a fraud upon me. There is a which he has not revealed to me at the time of the execution. So I am therefore compelled with no compelled to terminate the agreement. I have by my advocate notice terminated, cancelled the agreement. That is not sufficient. You have to file a suit for cancellation. In a civil suit, as filed either in the City Civil Court, Bombay, or Bombay High Court, depending upon the valuation, up to 1 crore, City Civil Court, above 1 crore, High Court, in the City of Bombay, elsewhere, a District Court, you'll go, or Civil Judge Senior Division, Junior Division, depending upon what the valuation. So, here to our next, yeah.
So, if the limits get changed and your case is ongoing, can you automatically switch to the next higher court if the, or is it only from prospective basis, so you're not eligible?
I didn't understand your question.
Supposing I had a suit that was running, that was worth, let's say, 50 lakhs. Mm. And it was in the small causes court. Mm. And then the limit got changed and said, you know, amount worth 50 lakhs and up can go straight away to high court.
Yes.
So can I take my suit out of there and put it directly in high court? Or
Naturally, when the court is not having jurisdiction, the court will ask you to plaint will be returned to you for presentation to proper court under Order 7, Rule 11. Order 7, Rule 10, A.
Will that apply only to new suits being filed, or will it apply also to the existing suits?
It depends upon the nature of the legislation, whether it's a prospective one or retrospective one. The Bombay High Court jurisdiction in the year about 3 years ago was enhanced City Civil Court from 15,000 to 1 crore, isn't it? So, sure. All suits which were pending in the High Court up to 1 crore were transferred to City Civil Court. All suits have been transferred. It is called a retrospective application. So, when the suit is transferred, you will be heard in another court. That is on the point of territorial jurisdiction, that is no depart. So, I am in the point that when you have exhibited a Xerox copy of the document to your plane for cancellation of the plane, and the original is in the possession of the defendant, then you have to mention in the plane the original document which is sought to be cancelled in the present suit is in the custody of the defendant. So at the time of the hearing of the suit or before the commencement of the trial, you will have to give a notice under section 66. Aap dekhiye 66 padhi aap the evidence hai. Rules has to notice to produce. Secondary evidence are the content of a document referred to in 65, clause A, shall not be given unless the party proposing to give such secondary notice has previously given to the other party. The party in possession to give such secondary evidence has previously given party in whose possession or power the document is, or to his attorney, pleader, such notice to produce is prescribed and so, and given, consider so. So, this notice is given by you when, after the court has framed the issues, directed you to lead evidence. It is at that time you are handicapped. You are not in a position to bring the original document because section 64 says, dekhiye, document must be proved by primary evidence. Samjhe na aap?
So if no primary evidence, then you lose the case, sir?
No, not lose. You are coming to secondary evidence. If there is no primary evidence, then you are leading secondary evidence. I am giving you the answer to first illustration. That is 65A. So, the document which is original in the possession of the defendant. So, defendant ke kabze mein document rahega. So, you are required to give a notice under section 66 of the Evidence Act calling upon the defendant, that is the builder, placing on record that look here, at the time of the booking of the flat, I had paid you so-and-so consideration. we got executed original, the document of the agreement of sale. You provided me a copy, true copy, and the original you took it from me on the ground that it is required to be sent for registration to Pune. Now, in the wake of the fact that I have cancelled the agreement, now the suit is ripe for hearing. It is time for recording evidence, and I am required to produce the document in the court to prove my case. You are hereby called upon to produce the original document in your custody, and please treat this notice as a notice under Section 66 of the Evidence Act, and produce the same in the court on the next date of hearing or until the witness is discharged. Failure to note that, I shall produce the copy which will be admitted. So after notice, if he doesn't bring it before the court, the original document, the court will take your Xerox copy. Your copy will become admissible. Your court will pass an order under Section 136, admissibility ke andar. Yes, the plaintiff has successfully proved before the court that this document is a vital document for cancellation. He has also proved before me that the original document is in the custody of the defendant, and he has proved before me that he has given a notice under Section 66 to defendant to produce, and the defendant, despite receiving the notice, has not produced it. So I therefore believe that the copy produced by him, Xerox copy, taken to be the secondary evidence, and the same is admitted in evidence.
The moment the secondary evidence becomes admissible, does it automatically also acquire the status of an original if the original is lost or cannot be produced?
Your purpose is served. Whether it acquires this status of a original is immaterial. It is a document which is admitted in the court of law for the purpose of your suit. Your suit can be either decreed or dismissed on that point. Okay?
Okay, sir. But if it is like a property registration, then it does not acquire the status of an original, right, sir?
No, it doesn't require. It is only when the original is, you are not in a position to produce it. Then you resort to the provisions of Section 66 and 65 and 63. You place before the court. Permit me to have one sip of water.
Please, sir.
Okay.
Sir, one question.
जी बोलिए.
What is the status of the certified copy of the registered document, whether it falls under primary or secondary?
Secondary evidence 65(1) में आ जाता है, 63(1) में आएगा.
Okay, but some documents are required to be proved only and only with the original or primary evidences, such as wills.
Yeah, will you have to produce before the court. Suppose the original is not very available, you can tell the court where it is, which place, kahan pe hai, kiske paas hai.
No, but in the case of it is registered under Registration Act.
Yes.
With the sub-registrar.
Yes, the registrar will be told to produce it before the court.
Okay, and that will be held as a primary evidence or secondary?
No, the registrar having the custody of the original, if he produces the original in the High Court, it's a primary evidence.
Because the
first copy itself is lying with him.
Okay.
Suppose if you obtain a certified copy of the original, he doesn't dispatch the original. He retains the original. He gives a copy to you, Xerox copy, and he puts his stamp. That is a secondary evidence.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. 65A का illustration समझ में आ गया ना? That is the original is in the custody of the person to whom you have given notice. Number two, any person out of reach or not in the possession, not in the process of the court. See, there are maybe about 13 situations where this document can come under court. Number one, it is in the custody of the person to whom you give a notice. Then number two, or any person out of reach. When somebody is out of reach, you may take up the plea, the original has been taken out, the copy, the original, is in the custody of my brother, who is settled down in USA, and I do not have his address. You may be filing a suit for partition. The original partition deed is with him. He's a big brother. The big brother may be not wanting to cooperate with you. You want to usurp your property. It may be in the custody of your uncle who is not traceable or who is dead and gone. So you may say that he is out of reach and not available, but I have a copy with me. Or not sufficient, the process of the court. Or the person who is not amenable to the court process. I mean, sometimes you know that in the CPC, you are taken, the court will not issue summons to a person who is outside the territorial jurisdiction, who is not available, more than 500 kilometers. So he is staying in a remote village in a different part of the different state. The address is not known to you. So if you take up the plea, the court is liberal. I have a copy, the court will believe it. That is, apart from the secondary evidence, you may also lead some corroborative piece of evidence under section 157, which we dealt with it here. That the document has been executed in the presence of XYZ. Heard it here. So it becomes number two illustration. Number three, Chakijiya. Of any person legally bound to produce it. Of any person legally bound to produce it, mean, for example, you gave me the example right now. Your grandfather's will has been registered, and registered document is in the custody of the registrar under the Registration Act. So when a notice is given to registrar, he is legally bound to produce it. Samjana aap? You got it? You may be having only a Xerox copy, but when you want to obtain the probate of the will, you will through the court of law, the court will issue a rule nicely to him, a direction, command. The petition has been filed, and I believe the original document is in your custody, and you are hereby called upon to produce the same. So he is a person legally bound. He is a trustee acting in a fiduciary capacity. He cannot misappropriate it. He cannot. Yes. Okay. You got it.
Yes.
Now item number four, Chikijiya. Then
what happens if the will has not been registered, and then what happens in this particular case? Then would the copy be treated?
No. It may not be registered. It may be in the custody of execututor. So the A and B are the beneficiaries. C is the executor. Your mama is the executor. He is trying to play tricks. You brothers are fighting over the property. Will ke baare mein. Baba, mama, as an executor, as a trustee, he cannot charge money. As a trustee, has to work in a fiduciary capacity, free of charge. And he's trying to blackmail you. So one of you may go to the court to file a petition for probate and obtain a direction that the original will is not in your custody. It is in the custody of the executor who is not producing. It is fundamental the duty of the executor to file a petition for executor. He is not coming forward. If he's not coming forward, the beneficiary can go under the Succession Act.
The copy will also become admissible, sir.
Yes. If he has to bring the original, otherwise the copy which you have got, the court will accept it. Both the parties may say, yes, this is the copy, unless it is not contested by both the side.
But sir, what example you have given, executor is the person who applies for the probate, no?
Yes, under the Succession Act. It is a mandatory duty of the executor. But executor not cooperating, it doesn't mean that you have no right.
You can
go for letters of administration. Isn't
yes,
it?
Yes. Under
the Succession Act, and the dual remedy. If he is not applying for probate, you go for letters of administration. Okay. If what cannot be attained directly can be obtained indirectly. Not to worry. Next item, dekh lijiye aap. Copy legally bound up then. When after notice mentioned in 66, such person does not produce it. So these are the example. So the notice dene ke baad, these are the person legally bound to produce it, you have to give a notice. Then clause B, check her up. When the existing condition, contents of the originals have been proved to be admitted in writing by the person against whom it is proved or by his representative in interest when the existing condition or content of the original have been proved to be admitted in writing by a person against whom it is proved or by his representative interest. So a document which is creating maybe a mortgage deed or maybe a license agreement, maybe a agency agreement which has been executed, which may be in the custody of the principal, which may be in the custody of the mortgager, which he is bound to produce it. If the mortgagee wants to go file a suit for foreclosure, or the mortgager has executed the document, the mortgagee is not returning, and mortgager want to file a suit for redemption under the provisions of Order 34 CPC, read with Section 58 to 70 of the Transfer of Property Act. So here the document is not disputed. So mortgage deed is a document under which you have taken loan. But for reason best known, with a view to prevent the mortgager from claiming redemption, you are dishonestly not giving him a copy. The original document you are withholding. Or maybe a trust deed, a trust created for the benefit of a small children. They attain majority. The trust deed is giving particulars as to how the property to be distributed. The trustee become dishonest. So under the provisions of the Indian Trust Act, there are provisions section 88, 90, 91, 92, how the trustee is enjoined with a duty to distribute the property. So document, agar they are not coming forward, you have a right to tell them produce the document. Or the copies which you may have obtained from other sources can be produced from the court of law. I mean, this document is existing. It is in this condition. The contents are correct. Samjana, a particular document, maybe for example, for construction of a building, of a property, of a hotel, of a building, family document, the executor must have used the document to obtain the permission from the municipal corporation. The municipal corporation will say, under what power you are applying this? Well, I am the executor. I am the trustee. I got a trustee. So when the plaintiff attains majority, he comes to know that permission for when you go to your lawyer, the lawyer will tell you, probably he has taken the permission from the corporation relying upon the original document trust deed. So check from the court record, from the record of the municipal corporation, such a copy is lying or not. So you can make an application to the municipal corporation. Please furnish me the Xerox copies or certified copies of the entire record and proceeding under which permission for development was given. I am the real owner, the beneficiary under the deed of my grandfather. The trustee is not discharging his duties. And he is usurping your property. I intend to file a suit. That is how it is, sir. Document given. Okay. Next, item number C, check kar lijiye aap. When the original has been destroyed. See, another example. C deals with a case. The original document has been destroyed. In many people in the city of Mumbai living in the footpath or, in a colonies, their documents are kept in the premises. The documents in the Bombay ka incident rain, they are destroyed. The government is giving protection to those slum dwellers who are in occupation prior to the 1st of May 2000. And your client is not able to produce the original document. I mean, Gumasta license, the permission letter from the competent authority. But you may be having a copy of it. So you may take up the plea that the original document has been lost in Bombay ka rain, incessant rain, in the floods. It is not traceable. However, I got a copy which I had given to my advocate to prepare a notice to give the government. It is the same copy. So I am relying upon, the license granted to you, those persons who are in occupation of the property, of the premises. You may be an unlawful occupant, you may be a trespasser. Certain dates you are staying in occupation. If you are a slum lord, you may be a slum occupant. Social welfare legislation like MHADA, Slum Act, Development Control Regulation, these are all, and they are giving you protection to stay, isn't it? So the government is announcing schemes. So we will provide accommodation to those people, those hutment dwellers who are in possession, who are staying in possession from 1st of May 2000. Agar wo document nahi hai aapke paas, original document, it doesn't mean that you will lose the case. You have to tell the court the original is lost or destroyed. When the party offering evidence, when the original has been destroyed or lost, when the party offering evidence of this content control cannot or any other reason arising from his own default neglect the procedure in reasonable. So you have to make an affidavit in the court of law stating that the original document has been misplaced, lost. Despite my diligent efforts, I could not trace the same. I, in fact, lodged a police complaint. There was a robbery in our colony, in my family. It may be possible that the robbers had taken away the original document. So they are not traceable, despite me. There is no, I was not negligent. It is not due to my fault. It is an account of the fault of the robbers. Isn't it? So, when the original document is lost or not traceable, the copy can be used by you as a secondary evidence in the court. Next, C, dekh lijiye aap. Now, C ho gaya. Then D, when the original is of such a nature as not to be easily movable, it's not a movable thing. It must be immovable. It may be a big rock. You cannot produce. You may be wanting to prove evidence before the court of law that you have a easementary right through the rocks and go before the court. You cannot bring the rock before the court. At the most, you may get the photographs, isn't it? A photograph taken of a rock is a secondary evidence. Of the mountain is a secondary evidence. You have taken a draft as a sketch. You may examine the person who drafted the sketch. It becomes a secondary evidence. You may take up the plea that I have an easementary right to come and go to this place, which the defendant is objecting. Under the Easement Act, the right of prescription is enjoyed by you. Item number E, check lijiye aap. When the original is a public document within the meaning of Section 74. So all public documents, I told you, come within the mischief of secondary evidence because the original documents you are not bringing. So, public document bole jitne bhi from the government authority of India, all tribunal, banks, public officer, legislative assemblies, Section 74 illustration diya. These are documents. Parliament is passing legislation. The deliberation meetings, you are not going to produce it. The Gazette of India is sufficient. It's a public document. An election commission is issuing you the election cards. They are public documents. The Aadhaar card is now given to you as a public document. The court will see the document and they mark and exhibit karenge aap.
Sir, yeah. Is the copy of FIR is a public document?
Not exactly. Maybe the seal of the police station. The seal of the police station may be taken and recorded as a public document, not the contents. Because the contents have to be proved by you separately. Malum na pe? The maker has to make the contents must be proved. Now that's
and sir, circulation of the FIR copy via internet or by the mode of electronic devices, can it become under libel or not libel? What you can say?
Mm. they are not public doc. They are not original documents. They are not original document. Please note that FIR has to be proved by you, because FIR is based upon your information, your contents. You have to step into the box. It's a It is not a substantive piece of document, nor statement made under 161 to police officer or a public document.
Yes.
Yes, the entries may be taken to be public document. The entry police officer has taken. Even in some cases, I held that your ration card is not a public document. Though it is coming from the public office, the entry may be taken. The court may rely upon the fact that, yes, the entries may be correct here. Okay. Now, the document mentioned in section...
So dissemination of FIR, will that become a crime if it's not a public document? Like somebody takes a photo of it and circulates it on WhatsApp.
That is what I was about to ask.
If it is hurting
you, defamatory hai kya wo?
Yes, if on account of the publication you have been defamed, you have a right to take action and under 499, 500, 502 of the IPC. It is a publication is not permitted of any document. If the FIR contains certain derogatory comments against you, and if it is being circulated to the entire public, that is a document which pertains to you. You cannot be defamed in this manner, because you cannot be convicted by the police authorities unless and until there is a complete charge. You presume to be innocent. You presume to be innocent until you are convicted by the court of law. So even before conviction, you are being defamed. You are defamed by people by circulating the FIR that don't believe him, don't trust him. So it all depends what kind of strictures they are passing against the person. What is the motive behind? Okay.
Sir, I have one question. When we are asking for documents under RTI, they normally give us a covering letter which contains the details of the documents that are attached. So in such a case, is it required that each copy of each document that they have attached has to be certified separately as true copy?
Not necessarily. Not necessarily. It is a continuation of paragraph wise, paging number. Paging number, and the first page and last page is signed, and it can be identified. The court may presume to be correct document.
Okay.
There is no necessity to each page to be attested.
So it has to be serially numbered.
Serially numbered, and paragraph should be matched. It is only when you go for a registration before the sub-registrar of assurance, they insist that each page should be, that will should be in, written by each page.
No, sir. I'm not talking about a will. What has happened is we had through RTI got certain documents from the registrar of firms with one partnership firm. Now, we've received the RTI covering letter which states that, so-and-so dated document is attached here with. But the documents that they have attached, that is not certified. But they have mentioned that.
But there's a mention about the document, isn't it?
Correct.
If they mention, that is appropriate.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Abhi. Then F check kijiye. When the original is a document which certified copy is permitted by this act or by any other law for the time in force in India to be given in evidence. Okay. This is a example under the Bankers Evidence Act. Okay. See that in a Bankers Evidence Act, when you file complaints under the provisions of a Negotiable Instrument Act 138, isn't it? Check is bounced, dishonored. So whether it is issued for enforcing legal liability or not. So you need not examine the banker. The banker certificate is enough. The bank issued certificate, yes, this particular check has been deposited in my bank. It has been dishonored. So, the Bankers Evidence Act, padenge Section 4, Ashitra Kholiye, Section 4 of the Bankers Evidence Act. the padhiye section 4 of the Bankers Evidence Act.
Of any entry in a banker's book shall in all legal proceedings be received as prima facie evidence of the existence of such entry and shall be admitted as evidence of the matters, transactions and accounts therein recorded in every case.
So, a bank issuing a certified copy coming under straight away under under clause F, you need not examine the bank manager. Please note that. Then G checker up.
So all banking records are prime evidence, sir?
I mean, under the Bankers Evidence Act, there's acceptable evidence, sir. So okay. There's a Bankers Evidence Act, which check up. There is one more, then next, F ho gaya. Then G check. When the original consists of numerous accounts or other documents which cannot conveniently be examined in the court and the fact to be proved is generally result of the whole collection. When the original consists of numerous accounts or other document which cannot be conveniently examined in the court and the fact to be proved is generally result of the whole collection. Now here the example is a Government of Government India ka Gazette. Government of Maharashtra MCC Gazette. Oh, Gazette ke andar several laws have been passed, several documents are kept together. Now, for example, if you go to police station, remand application, check karenge, magistrate court mein jayenge aap, they have maintained the record of hundreds of peoples of FIR and the remand application. So, the all documents which are kept in the original FIR or the government, government gazette, you when you go in the High Court Law Library, you will find the MGG Government Gazette, Gazette of the Union of India, Gazette of the Union Territory. So each of the document need not be produced. All are original documents. So numerous documents are kept here. They are all original documents. They all maintain.
So one question, sir. So ye Bankers Evidence Act Section 4 mode of proof and of entries ke bare mein hai. ये बैंक स्टेटमेंट्स जो होते हैं वो प्राइमरी होते हैं कि सेकेंडरी होते हैं?
दे आर सेकेंडरी एविडेंस, दे आर
सेकेंड मेंशन इन द सेक्शन लाइक दैट.
दे आर सेकेंड, नाउ दे आर मेंशन हियर ना, सेक्शन 65F अभी पढ़ा.
दे आर सेइंग इट इज एडमिसिबल एज एन एविडेंस बट दे आर नॉट, दे आर एडमिसिबल,
दे आर एडमिसिबल एज सेकेंडरी एविडेंस बिकॉज़ द बैंक इज नॉट
सेकेंडरी.
द बैंक इज गिविंग यू इट्स सिग्नेचर एंड प्लेसिंग ऑन रिकॉर्ड स्टेटिंग दैट दिस इज अ डॉक्यूमेंट from our record. So
it falls under the secondary evidence, right?
Yes, it's a secondary evidence.
Okay.
And the document which is kept in their own bank, they will not part with the original because ek particular account holder ke naam ek sheet ke andar lakho aur naam rahenge, isn't it?
Yes.
The bank maintains the record of maybe 1000 account holder.
Yes.
So there is no need to take it. A landlord maintains the name of several tenants, the counterfoils of rent receipts. You know, each of them may be relevant. That comes within the purview of Section 65, Clause F. Check karna, F and G, numerous document. Now, in case A, B, C, D, secondary evidence of a content of a document admissible. Now, in case of B, where they admissible, in case of A, certified copy, but no other kind of secondary illustration. In case of G, evidence may be given as a general result of document by person skill. Okay? These are the illustration example. Now, the topic which we are going to discuss from the judgment of the Supreme Court, in the various judgment and the last of which is Arjun Pandit Rao Kotkar judgment, will come under Section 65B. Admissibility of electronic record. What is the time, Ashish, now?
7:36, sir.
Abhi hum log kabhi shuru kiye, abhi ek break lenge isko zara padhne ke liye.
Haan sir.
Ek break lo, chai pi ke aa jao, 5 6 minute aa jao. Okay, thank you.
Okay.